we'll just go on to some more detailed study about the arithmetic operators, maybe a few programs, and in order to understand it. For that, you just go to File, New File. Here we are going to write a script now. How are we going to write a script? Say, for example, we are going to define two variables. Let's say A is equal to 2 and I say B is equal to 3. I say B is equal to 3. And now I want to do a particular operation. Okay, what kind of operation do I want to do? I want to do some kind of arithmetic operation. So I say print what? Print, I'm going to print A. Okay, and if I want, I can print two values, A comma B. Okay, let's see what this returns for me. So when I say this is my, okay, this I just finished my first.py. Now I can just say I'm learning arithmetic, so I'll just put arithmetic.py. So print A comma B. This is how you will just put it onto your script. Now I want to run it. Of course, I'm going to press F5. When I press F5, you know, you can see the output. It restarted the shell here and the output is seen here. It printed A comma B for me. But no, I want to print something else along with it. I want to print A plus B also. I want to print A plus B. So can I say, when I save it, 2 plus 3 is 5. Now, can I print something like this? Can I print A minus B? Yes, A minus B, and I say F5. Okay, it says 2, 3, 5 and minus 1. Okay, hope you are getting a hang of how the print function, or how you can write a particular script. Okay, so in the print function can take multiple values, as you can see, A, B, A plus B, A minus B, and so on. Okay, now there is something which I want you to notice. You know, I might sometimes not want to give my, over here I have assigned my A as 2 and I have assigned my B as 3, but it doesn't happen like that in real time. A lot of times you might want to ask the user to input some values. Okay, so how do I tell the user, can you please input some values and I want to see that? Okay, so how do I do that for the user? Is it possible for me to do it? Yes, it is. How can I input some values from the user? Okay, how do I do it? I'll again have to go back to my documentation, help, go to my documentation, that is Python docs. In Python docs, I need to go again for library reference. In library reference, I go for built-in functions. In built-in functions, I need to have a look. Is there something, is there a function which tells me, which can help me in taking an input from the user? Yes, 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 there is a function called as input. If I go to input, it says input and then says, please put a prompt, which means the prompt is, what does it say? Prompt is nothing but I can just tell the user something in this prompt. I can just tell him, please enter a value. That's it. So this prompt is nothing but telling the user what he has to do. So let me do it in the shell and try it before I put it onto the script. How do I go to the shell? Go to the other slide, that is Python 3.4.3 shell, and we can try it here. Okay, if you want, you can just restart it all together. So I restart my shell. And when I restart my shell, I can see, okay, I'll just take this a bit on top. All right, so in my restarted shell, can I write here something like, you know, I want to input from the user. So I'm going to say input, and I can give a prompt over here. So I can say enter some value. Okay, so I say enter some value. Okay, and then it says enter some value. So he enters, let's say 5, and I say enter. Now, when you entered 5, Python just displayed it back to me, right? Now, but this value which the user has entered, have I saved it somewhere? Has this been saved somewhere? No, I didn't save it. Python just displayed it back for me, okay? But can I get this input some other, you know, I have input something from the user, but I didn't save it. How do I access it? No, I didn't save it, man. So what should I do? I need to save whenever the user enters something, I need to save it. How do I save it? I save it into something called as a variable. We just saw that. Okay, we can save it into something called as a variable. So how do I save it into a variable? Can I say my variable? Let me call a variable called as num. And I say input. Now I say input. Enter some value. Okay, and now when I say enter, he enters 5, and I say, and now if I say num, it tells me there is 5. Okay, But there is a small problem. Can I see what is the type of this num? Can I see what is the type? Says it is a string, which means it is not user has input what? It is, he has input an integer. But when while accepting it, the Python program in the input function, through the input function, he has inputted it and saved it as a string. That means that can cause me some problems. Why it will cause me some problems? Sir, what if I do, you know, what if I say I want to do this particular number 5 multiplied by 5? Okay, I'm very genuinely saying I want to multiply this number. I want to multiply it by 10. I want to multiply it by 10. Okay, so I can use my arithmetic operator, that is the multiplication operator, and I say multiply it by 10. What do you expect as an answer? You would expect 5 into 10, that is 50. But what actually it gives me is 5 printed 10 times. Why is that so? Because 5 is considered as a string. And when you multiply a string by 10, it makes the same string multiplied by 10 times and then gives it to you. So that means, and this is not a very good option for me, which means when I input something from the user, I need to convert it into an integer and then put it into number. How do I convert it into an integer and then put it into num? Is it possible for me? Yes, it is possible. Can we have a look? How is it possible? You need to go to the documentation. In the documentation, you need to go to the built-in functions and check. You need to check, sir, is it possible for me that I can convert a string into an integer? Yes. Is it possible? Oh, yes. It is possible with a function called as int. Int, what does it do? It returns an integer object from a number or from a string.